Hello scholars, today we are starting chapter number 6, Saudi Arabia, the land of hot sand. In the previous chapter, we have read about a region having extremely cold climate. In this chapter, we will discuss about a region of the world experiencing hot climate. Deserts are the areas of the world with very low rainfall, which also experience extremes of hotness and coldness. There are two types of deserts, hot deserts and cold deserts. Arabian, Thar and Sahara are the example of some hot deserts, whereas Ladakh and Gobi are the cold deserts of the world. In this chapter, we will learn about the Arabian desert with the example of Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia is located in the Arabian desert. It is surrounded by the Red Sea in the west, Arabian Sea in the south, and Persian Gulf and Gulf of Oman towards the east. In the north, Jordan, Israel, Iraq and Kuwait are situated, whereas Yemen, Oman and UAE are located in the south. The Tropic of Cancer passes through Saudi Arabia. Let us see the landscape of Saudi Arabia. Most of Saudi Arabia is a rocky plateau covered by vast desert. Deserts are covered with small hills of sand called sand dunes. These sand dunes are not stationary at one place. They keep moving around. How do they move around? Because of very strong winds and dust storm, these sand dunes shift from one place to another. There are no lakes, no rivers in this region, but at some places, underground water sources come up to the surface and this forms a fertile area called oasis. You can see that this is not a lake, but it is groundwater that has surfaced up. It has come from underground and all sand around the oasis becomes fertile, because of which plants start to grow. Nowhere in the desert land there are any plants, but around the oasis you can see some plants growing. Let us see the climate of Saudi Arabia. As we know that the Tropic of Cancer passes through the center of Saudi Arabia, because of this, the climatic conditions of Saudi Arabia is very, very hot and dry. And the country gets very little rainfall. The humidity is also very low and the sun seems to be shining brightly throughout the year. Whether it is winter, whether it is summer or whatever season it may be, the sun is shining brightly. And if you remember in the chapter climate, we studied all of these conditions are perfect for deserts to form. And so the days are very hot and sunny. Whereas if we see nights, the nights are cool. Why? Because the sand cools down very quickly at night. Now let us move on and see the vegetation and agriculture that can be achieved in this area. In a desert, there are very few plants that can grow. If you remember, in the chapter of Greenland, we said that only those plants that can survive in extreme cold can grow there. In the same way, In Saudi Arabia, only plants that can withstand in very hot and dry conditions can survive here. For example, cacti and certain short shrubs. Apart from this, when there is an oasis and fertile land, plants like date palms and certain crops like wheat and barley are cultivated around the oasis. Let us talk about the economy of Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia is a very rich country as it has very vast deposits of mineral oil. There are many oil refineries in Saudi Arabia where crude oil is converted into petroleum, diesel, kerosene, and many other useful products. People mainly deal with petroleum and they call it as the liquid gold. Most of these products are exported to almost every country of the world, and by selling them, the money that they earn used for building modern cities and developing the country. And also, several large industries have been set up at Saudi Arabia by using the money earned by selling petroleum. These industries are petroleum refining industries, iron and steel plants, cement industries, and fertilizer industries. Also, the stores in the cities are full of good quality textiles, jewelry, electrical and electronic goods, computers, and automobiles. This has further increased the wealth and prosperity of the people of Saudi Arabia due to the development in the economy and increased wealth. The people of Saudi Arabia have all the modern facilities and the standard of living is also quite high. There are also a lot of Indians who settle in the parts of Saudi Arabia. Now, an interesting thing is that though there are modern facilities and development in the Saudi Arabia, when we see the society, it is very, very traditional and it is ruled by the king. When we say traditional, we see that there are certain rules and regulations to be followed. Like, women have to wear abaya. What is abaya? Abaya is a traditional black dress that leaves only eyes open, which Saudi Arabian women have to wear when they go out. This is not just women. Men also have a traditional dress. A long cotton gown called a thob, which is sometimes covered by a jacket or a robe. And they also cover their head with gutra, which is used to protect their head from the sun, and it is held in place with a ring. This is about the people of current Saudi Arabia. When we look at the original or the traditional people of Saudi Arabia, we find that the traditional people of Saudi Arabia were nomads. Even today, many people follow this nomadic lifestyle. They are called as Bedouins. When we see their lifestyle, their main occupation is rearing cattle, and they move from one place to another in search of pastures for their flock of goat, sheep, and camels. The common way in which they used to survive is they used to go and sell the goods like lambs, sheep, goats, camels, cheese, wool, blanket, carpets, ornaments, and guns at a nearby village to get some money, with which they buy food grains and they live in tents made of animal skin. The Bedouins move in caravans. They carry their tents, belongings, animals, and families with them. To travel in desert, they use camels, as camels are very useful in the deserts. They can move easily and quickly on hot burning sand. Even camels can live without water for many days. Thus, they are also called as the ship of the desert. But now, more and more people are moving towards villages and towns, and they have started living their life with the use of modern tools, techniques, and modern lifestyle. Apart from all of this, Saudi Arabia also has a religious importance. The religion Islam was founded by Prophet Muhammad in Saudi Arabia. Millions of Muslims from all over the world come to Mecca and Medina, the most important pilgrimage centers for Muslims. These are the holy places of the Muslims. Other significant cities are Riyadh. Riyadh is the capital city. It is a modern town with skyscrapers, parks, markets, educational institutions, and hospitals. Jeddah is located on the west coast along the Red Sea. It is the major business center and an important seaport on the western side. Together with this, King Abdul Aziz International Airport is one of the largest airports in Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia is the best example to show that even the land is hot, dry, and barren, then also Saudi Arabia is converted into a rich and prosperous place. And the government of Saudi Arabia has done everything possible and has intelligently used their natural resources for the benefit of the people. Today, Saudi Arabia has grown into a modern nation due to the hard work and efforts of the people. Now, we have come to the end of the chapter. So, let us revise what we have studied today. Today, we have studied chapter number 6, Saudi Arabia, the land of hot sand. And in this chapter, we have studied that Saudi Arabia, a country in the Middle East, is located in the Arabian Desert. The general climate of Saudi Arabia is hot and dry. Saudi Arabia has vast deposits of mineral oil, which is exported to almost every country of the world. Mecca and Medina, the two most important centers of pilgrimage for Muslims, are located here. Riyadh and Jeddah are the two significant cities of Saudi Arabia. Camel is used to carry loads in the hot burning sand. Bedouins are the traditional people of Saudi Arabia. The lifestyle of Bedouins is changing now. Saudi Arabia has grown into a modern nation due to the hard work and efforts of the government and the people of the country. I hope you have understood the chapter. Do the reading of the chapter and complete your written work in book, copies, and worksheets in a file or register. For exercises, question answers, and worksheets, you can refer the link given in the description box. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.